In this video, you are going to learn the answers to 5 common questions that come up when setting up Chargent's automated collections add-on module. My name is Stacy, and I'm from Chargent. If you are a Salesforce admin or consultant who wants to learn about payments and be a superstar for your organization, then you are in the right place. So why automated collections? When you are trying to deal with the problem of failed payments, Chargent's automated collections module does just that. From sending email reminders to payment request links, your configurable dunning, you know those retries of payments that did not go through. Chargent Automated Collections makes it easy to set up any accounts receivable or collections process. Best of all, it runs automatically in the background, contacting your customers to capture payments and setting them back on their recurring schedule once the missed payment has been successfully made. Your team doesn't have to lift a finger. We found that some common questions do come up when customers are configuring automated collections. So here are 5 popular questions. Question 1, how do I add old failed payments into the automated collections process? Recurring or scheduled payments are automatically added to the automated collections process when a payment is declined or there is some other problem causing it to be missed. But what if you have other payments that failed and which were not part of your automated collections configuration? Easy, just change the payment status on those records from error, where they would likely be after a failure, to recurring. The next time Chargent runs its recurring batch, it will attempt to capture the payment. If it fails again, as we might expect with the payment method that needs updating, it will then be added into the automated collections process. Easy, right? While we are talking about easy solutions, I want you to know about a special checklist that we made for folks that watch these videos on 10 ways to make Salesforce payments safe, easy, and profitable. Go to the description below and click the link to download now. Now, question 2, when should I set up automated collections to run? Chargent recommends running your automated collections batch 1 or 2 hours after your regular Chargent recurring batch. You just want to make sure it starts once the recurring batch has completed. Chargent's default for recurring is 3 a.m., so for most customers, 4 a.m. is the perfect time to schedule the automated collections batch. If you don't know what time your batch runs, have a very high volume of recurring transactions that might take more than 1 hour to complete, or you need assistance with something else, as always, our support team is here to assist you. So please reach out. To know how long your batch takes to run, just look at the Create Dates field for your batches and the resulting transaction records. You can see if it is 3 minutes or 3 hours. Most are less than 30 minutes. Question 3, how can I test automated collections so it doesn't email customers I don't want? Great question, and we appreciate customers who do careful testing. We have some other great videos here on the Chargent YouTube channel for how to do testing in Salesforce sandboxes, complete with tips on setting up your data to limit any emails and prevent customer data from being changed. We also have a document, Testing Automated Collections, that our support team can share with you with some tips on how to set up test records and how to trigger the batch manually so you don't have to wait for your whole collections process to run in real time. Question 4. Can I text people collections notices or alerts about failed payments? Why, yes, you can. Notably, SMS is not part of Chargent out of the box, but there are a variety of third-party SMS apps on the Salesforce App Exchange. Using SMS apps, you should be able to send a template with the payment request link automated collections generates right to your customer's cell phone. Talk to your Salesforce administrator or consultant to learn more about the implementation and options of SMS apps for Salesforce. Now, question 5. What do you recommend if automated collections are not successful? If automated collections are not successful, meaning the retried payments still fail and your customer does not respond to the emails, never fear. Many customers have the final email template CC'd to a ticketing system email, so a case is opened for your customer service or billing team to take over. Alternatively, one could use Salesforce automation to assign a task to a Salesforce user for manual email or phone follow-up. Often a customer just needs a phone call to encourage them to take action. It is also possible that your email contacts are out of date and that a team member needs to do a little research to find a new contact or email address to reach out to. The good news is, with automated collections, your accounting staff only needs to handle these edge cases. Customers who are responsive have their billing updated automatically in the background, often after hours when your team is not even working. And now, check out this next video, where you'll learn more about Chargent Automated Collections and how it can help your business lower costs, improve revenue, and make your life easier. My name is Stacy, and at Chargent, we're dedicated to helping Salesforce customers like you keep your payments simple. And remember, we're always here to help.